Alright, this is the 36 hole summary for the boys 12 to 13. And this is Karl's scorecard so far. He's had 72 and 69, so par of 72 and 3 under 69. And at the moment, as we await a rain delay, he's the first two holes, and he's 110 yards out on the third hole in the middle of the fairway.
Third to play, Karl Vilips, Melbourne, Australia. Good luck today.
Carl's had another good drive on the first. He's going to be going for the green in two again. I think he's about 225 out. Just not sure which club to go, because he's going to have to come into this flag with a cut. So he's gone one more time. This be his 5 wood. Oh, he's right next to the flag again for the second day running. So he's got that putt there for eagle. Seems to like his first hole. That's a really good shot here by two ex-roommates. 480 yard par 5 in there, both within 15 to 20 feet. It's pretty neat. Right, Karl for his eagle putt. A little more than 15 feet. Oh, very good. It's a nice type of tapping birdie. Alright, Karl's off on the par 4 second hole tee box. The hole shapes right to left once it gets past that bunker that you can see on the left side. So he's going to be hitting a 3 wood. You can see what he's done there is just hit a 3 wood, so it leaves him with pretty much 100 yards to the hole. Yesterday hit a drive that actually went through the fairway, so today he's wanted to make sure that he was hitting off the cut stuff. Karl's intentionally left himself with just over 100 to the flag so that he can come in with the club. That's why he laid back with a 3 wood, so that he could use the full club and have a lot more control over his yardage. He's starting this on the right lip, and I wouldn't go giving the hole away because it's not going to break as much as what it looks. Good, back to back birdies. So the co-leaders each birdied that hole, and Karl had to sink that putt to stay 1 shot ahead. If you're wondering why Karl hasn't got to hit off first, it's because being the overnight leader, he was last to hit off the first tee. Him and the lad that just hit off then have both buried each of the first two holes. It's a tough gig. Carl's used a 3-wood off the tee here, whereas the other two rounds he's used driver, because he knows that if he uses 3-wood, it takes the water to the right of the fairway out of play. And it's still only going to leave him with a full wedge. I can see all three boys relatively the same length off the tee. Now, the reason that Carl's given up in excess of 50 yards is because he knows that he can still get to this green with just a pitching wedge, and by using was probably a 5-wood off the tee, he's taken it out all the hazards that were in play. He knew that with that club he could clear the fairway bunker that was about 180 out, but that he wouldn't reach the serious hazards. So we need to play a little bit smarter. But you might be able to hear some thunder in the background here. So it's not long before the heavens start to open and they stop playing again. Yep, there's the horns.
Well, just like the last couple rounds, I started off great. I went birdie-birdie on the first two holes, and then I piped my drive down the middle of the fairway on the third hole. And I was about to step up to my 130-yard shot with a pitching wedge, and the horn blew. We had to wait for 3.5 hours, which was a really long time, just sitting in a room in the same chair. And then we got back out without, and I put my pitching wedge to 10 feet below the hole and missed the putt, which was a par. And then, because it was so wet, the ball could easily embed in the fairways or the rough. And on the fourth hole, I hit my drive through the fairway, and I lost it in the rough, and I walked off that hole with a triple bogey.
Sure enough, the first hole back after the rain delay, Carl had a triple bogey.
When I got to the par 3 fifth hole, I hit my 7-iron over the green at 160 yards. And I had about a 30-foot putt to go, and I left it about 5 feet short. Now, the other guy was already leading me by 3. And he hit his putt about 5 feet by 2. Then I went first, and I knew that I had to make this, otherwise I would have fallen behind. I didn't think he was going to miss his putt. But I putted it knowing I had to make it, and it went in. And sure enough, he missed his putt, so it dropped back to a 2-shot lead.
Right, Carl's going to fight back now. He's 1 shot down. Still 13 holes to play. A lot can happen in 13 holes, as he's just found out at the Junior Worlds last week. It's going to go back to basics. It's very hard not being able to have a warm-up before you come back out. And what he's going to be doing here is taking relief because of this heavy downpour. The lower parts of the fairways are very wet, so he's found a place where there's no water squishing up under the shoes. He's taking a free drop. You're allowed to clean the ball under the rule. You'll be able to take a free drop on a reasonable part of the fairway. Casual water just means that the water's not squishing up when you stand on it. Otherwise, it's just simply impossible to get good contact on the ball. Well, as I say, hopefully Carl's using a club less than what he would have used before they stopped for play. Otherwise, this will go straight over the back of the green. Good shot under the flag that locks in his par for the hole and gives him a really good look at birdie. Carl's going to be lining up his birdie putt on the sixth hole. There's a high chance that he'll take the lead back to almost a sure on this hole. Good speed. I think he rightly thought it was going to break towards the front of the green, so I was surprised a bit there too. But, right, we're on the par 3 7th. I was going to be trying to fight against this, his natural jaw shape with his tee shot here, so he can get the ball to sit nice and soft. He's trailing the leader by one shot. He has caught up one. He's still, everything with Karl's with an eye in the hand goes left. And that's something that we desperately need to work on in the next week. Karl for his birdie. I'd say it's probably about 20 feet. His karate moves there give us a good indication of what he thought of that. Still tapping part. He's only missed it by an inch or two. Absolutely smashed that. Yeah, got that. Good drive. I think you should be able to see it just here. Nothing wrong with the driver now. How wet the course is after that deluge. This was all dry a couple of hours ago. These are a couple of new lakes that they put in the last few hours just to add to the appearance. Carl's got about 100 yards. So we're going to stick this one nice and tight. It's okay. Carl's got a birdie putt to pull one back and only be two behind. It's currently three behind. He needs to get one of these every few holes. There's still nine holes after this one. Like a photocopy of chill out a bit, Carl. Still nine holes to play. The only three shots back with nine holes to play. A lot of things can happen between now and then.
And then it got to the 13th hole, which is a pretty long par 3, 170 yards.
This little bowl is just a barrel of fun. Now, Carl, you're three shots back. This could actually suit you. If you can really knuckle down and suck it up over this next couple of holes, because Luke's got a good 40-foot putt, which isn't going to be a normal 40-foot putt if it's
cut. I blocked my 7-9 into the right bunker.
Next challenge is going to be finding the ball, because the bunkers are turned into lakes. So the player's actually got the rules official there, so just check with her where he could drop it. So the rule of course is that he's just going to find his ball somewhere in the lake there and take it drop at the nearest point, not near the hole. So it's a good, fun family sport. So I take it and drop. It's a three drop because the water, the bunkers turn into a lake. I would be dropping it on the ground.
Because it was really heavy rain, we're all soaked and all the greens were wet, the bunkers were full of water, so I had to take relief in the downslope at the back of the bunker. Now the greens were full of puddles, so I knew my ball was probably going to hold up. So I just knew I had to, I knew I was going to at least catch up one shot, because he had about a 40-foot putt up the hill through the water. And I put my bunker shot to 4 feet, and then I made my putt for par, which caught me up two shots on him.
So he's going to catch up at least one shot here. One of the challenges that the players face when it's this wet is hanging onto their clubs. And unfortunately, the players are not allowed to use their normal push carts here. Normally, Carl would have his push cart set up with the umbrella actually attached to it, so it's hanging up permanently, and he would hang his towels underneath the umbrella, but he hasn't been able to do that, and all of his towels are wet. like snap. Let's see how it goes. Yeah, that's fine. A little chip there. Just can't take bogey on this hole after catching out two strokes on the last hole. Yeah, good shot. Keep your eyes on it. It's just by having gone past, it's giving you a read. Okay, this for a good little up and down to stay one shot back. No pulling the putter now, champ. Just keep that putter face square. Well done. Good up and down. Makes a big difference when you get the ball going past the hole. But getting the ball past the hole with a chip gave Karl a read of what it was going to do while it's coming back.
Then I got to the 15th hole, which is a dogleg right par 4 with water all the way down the right. Now, all my grips and gloves were wet, so I had to swing smooth and I was comfortable hitting it smooth, assuring I was going to be on the fairway. And I put it in the middle with 165 yards to go to the hole.
Onto this grip. You can see he's really slow to swing down so that he can maintain the control of the club. You don't go giving it 100% swing when everything's wet. Alright, Karl's had a good drive. Yeah, so he's not trying to smash his driver. It's got a good look at the green here. Likes it. Let's see if we can't get it a good look here. Oh. It's about 3 feet from the hole. Now, Karl's one shot back at this stage, and the leader is in a spot of bother. So it could be a completely different ball game after this hole. Now, Karl is 3 shots back, so he's just been sticking at his task.
Put my 6-iron about 10 feet past, but I unfortunately missed the putt.
We're all tied up at the top. Right, on the last par 3, it's all tied up. So Karl's chipped away at his 3-shot deficit. It's taken a couple of hours. He's just chipped away until he's got level with a couple of holes left to play. I'm not sure whether this is 16 or 17. I think it might be hole 16. Yeah, good shot.
Then on 16, which is a par 3, 150 yards, I put my 7-iron about 30 feet long, leaving me with a downhill tricky putt.
That car's got a long distance putt. He's going to be aiming to get this down in two. Just lag it down to the hole.
I put my putt about 5 feet by. And also, this time, I also knew I had to make it to not lose any shots on them. He left his putt short, so I had to make it no matter what. I drained the putt, and I was super happy, because that was just the, that was really good for me.
17th hole. It's all even at the top of the leaderboard. Perfect. Good try.
Coming into 17, we were all square. These two holes are really tricky holes. 17 is a dogleg left par 5 with water all the way down the left on the green. I piped my drive down the middle of the fairway and then laid up short of the water near the green.
At the par 5 17th, Carl's going to lay up with a 5-iron. So he takes a lay cap that's in play just in front of the green. Carl's exactly holding out. Hopefully he's aware that he can't put this left of the pin because it will feed down into the lake. He likes it.
And then I hit my shot to about 12 feet left of the flag, and he hit is about 30 feet long, which left him with a downhill putt.
Carl's chipped away and chipped away to come back from a three-shot deficit with 6 holes to play. And he finds himself, if he can two-putt this, he's probably going to find himself with a one-shot lead. So, ran that past a bit. That's no gimme. I would have been just lagging that and going for the two-putt, so.
He three-putted, which gave me an opportunity to catch up two and go two ahead, but I missed my putt and only caught up one shot.
Well done. So that will give him at least a one-shot lead going into the final hole.
Coming into the 18th hole, I'm one ahead. 18 is a dogleg right with a bunker down the right side, trees on the right, and water all the way down the left.
Oh, Carl's leading by one. There's water all the way down the left, so it's got to hit this straight. It's no gimme.
So I couldn't see where the ball went because the sun was right into my face and I hit it into the right trees. Now when I walked up to my ball, I couldn't believe it. These gardeners had gathered up all the twigs from the rainstorm a couple days ago, just in this one spot where my ball happened to be right in the middle of it. So I had to try to move all these trees or branches away from my ball. It took a lot of patience, but in the end I still had a couple there that I couldn't move, otherwise my ball would have moved. Oh, but that lifted this thing and moved.
But the ball, I didn't see, the ball didn't move. It just made very, very careful. Yeah. It's like playing pickup sticks.
Now I tried to play safe and punch out just up the fairway, leaving me about 40 yards to the green. But I got caught up in the rough, apparently, just right behind the tree that I had in front of me. Just tried to punch on back past the flag, which would have left me 2-putt bogey. Instead, I chunked it, and it landed in the face of the bunker and came back down into the bunker.
Because he has to assume that he's, that the other player is going to get up and down. Fortunately, the other player is playing first. He's... you could regard that as being up and down. So Carl's got to get this.
I got into the bunker on the right with my shot from the behind the tree. And I didn't know if it was going to come out hot or if it was just going to plop out because the sand was so wet. Well, it just plopped out. And I didn't even run on it, just checked out. And I just left it short with 15 feet to go. And in my head, I was thinking, hit it past the hole, hit it past. And I'd left it short, like, 3 inches short, and I was like, oh my gosh. In the end, I ended up losing by one, and I really was not happy about losing by one shot, which sucks. Next morning, I look back thinking, well, I learned a lot more than winning this tournament than, well, I lost.
Thank you.